The Census Bureau finds record levels of taxation at the state and local level. You thought it was just the federal government, right? Americans are paying out a record $114 billion in state and local individual income taxes in the second quarter of this year alone, a 7% increase from the previous all-time record set in the second quarter of 2008. Also reaching record levels, the number of us who think the federal government has far too much power. A new Gallup poll shows 6 in 10 Americans believe government is simply too powerful. 32% say the government has the right amount of power. 7% say it has too little. 7% say that. Well, it's a beginning. Joining me now, the A-Team, author, radio talk show host, Fox News contributor, Monica Crowley, Fox News legal analyst, Lise Wheel, Democratic strategist, Hank Shinecoff. Hank, in celebration of your return after you, so Lou. Many weeks off here, what do you make of a country that that right now finds record levels of taxation not only at the state level but the local level? We're talking $100 billion a quarter.
This is called bipartisan upset. Country is very upset, and it has a lot to do with how people view government and how they feel it's out of control and it just has too much power. People feel very much out of control and being set upon by the people they elect to office. It's not good, Lou.
No, well, there is that 7%. So,
they're,
I mean, there
they
is
want
that.
More power.
They want
bless
more
them,
power
bless them.
Who are
yeah,
these
they,
people? Would you call them fascists? Or
I don't know where they're living under rocks, I think, those people. I mean, I'm surprised they could actually take the poll.
But it is striking to see 60% of the American people say government has too much power and the government is overreaching, whether you're talking about Obamacare,
right.
whether you're talking about taxation. The
why don't the Republicans talk about that very issue?
And they should be. This is their topic. They are supposedly the party of limited government, fiscal responsibility, and yet we've seen very little languaging on that.
Here's a caller right now. Let's show Senator Cruz still talking on the floor of the United States Senate, talking about the issues with Obamacare. It's extraordinary. $1.8 trillion they're going to spend. They won't even cover 30 million Americans. Only 50 million were without coverage, they said. That means they're spending $1.8 trillion, solving 40% of a problem, and destroying the healthcare system as they do it. We're going to have a shortage of doctors, Hank, by 2025 of 130,000 physicians. That's madness.
We can call it Obamacare or anything else. This is not a solution for anything. And what it will ultimately do, and what is wrong with this idea, is that it is empowering one sector of the economy, the insurance industry, at the expense of the healthcare system,
and that's
just plain wrong.
Example after example after example of people, you know, regular people getting hurt by this right now.
This is not about Democrat or Republican, Lou. This is about wrong.
Right, exactly.
It is wrong. But there is, instead of talking about procedural issues, which is what we are effectively left with here in this fight, and thank goodness for Senator Paul and Senator Cruz, mm-hmm. Senator Lee, we're at the establishment. Republican Party is bailing on these guys.
Spineless weasels. They're a bunch of spineless weasels. The reason that Ted Cruz is having traction now, even if he loses this defunding debate, which looks like he will because
right.
arithmetic is not on his side, right. but the reason he's gaining traction here, and the American people are paying attention to it, is what we just discussed. Obamacare, healthcare reform was never about healthcare. You could talk about the hemorrhaging of doctors until you're blue in the face. For the left, for Obama, Reid, Pelosi, and the left, Obamacare was always about government power and control. We just talked about 60% of the American people who think the government has too much mm-hmm. power. Obamacare is the ultimate case in point.
There's a large moral issue involved here as well that no one's paying, that people don't want to talk about. By this legislation, and controlled by one industry, okay, we are going to see the determination finally once and for all of who will live and who will die based upon cost. If the actuarial table says that 30%, that 40% of every healthcare dollar is used in the last 30 days of life, we're going to see people killed or not being allowed to have care at particular times.
Wait a minute.
And this is wrong.
Okay, right. You're a Democrat.
I know.
Sarah Palin used the expression death panels and was hooted down by the left, by the Democratic Party, by the administration, by the national liberal media.
Yep.
And this is before you'd read the legislation, right?
Before I said this, as a matter of fact, we had this discussion on this program. You were kind enough to allow it. some time ago. This is wrong morally.
Shankov.
This is morally reprehensible. And by the way, one nation under God does not do such things.
Look, the reason that Obama, Pelosi, and Reid and the left pushed this when the American people were screaming about jobs and the economy very early on is because the control of the healthcare system is the crown jewel of the welfare state. This is what the left has been agitating for decades. They finally got it.
Republicans can't come up with a coherent, compelling argument to express the reality that is it devastates our
devastating
healthcare.
Absolutely economically devastating,
but why can't
politically
the Republicans
devastating
scratch?
They're
the
also
Democrats.
Facing I'm gonna put my lawyer head on they're also facing the Supreme Court decision, you know, so they've got to, I mean, yes, they can unlegislate.
It's the law
this.
Of the land,
right?
It is validated,
right,
law of
the
land by the U.S. Supreme Court.
Right, right.
Right, but we have the Constitution, the ultimate law of the land, and that's what Ted Cruz is talking about right now. And he's got the American people on his side, and the Republicans can't make heads or tails out of that.
Turn out the vote in 2012. Will they be able to turn out the vote and win the elections in 2014?
I don't know about winning the elections, but
well, if they don't win them, they're through. There won't be... you know, we'll have a lot of people maybe standing in a well somewhere in this House or the Senate,
right.
But it will be to no effect.
Right.
They've got to win elections.
The strategic argument here, and not strict practical politics, is for the Democrats to permit as much confusion to occur as possible so the Republicans will do and be forced to appear like they're doing what they did in 1995, which was to shut the government down and to behave in such a way as they became a
barrier. If
the Republicans come out with their one-trick ponies, talking about deficits, talking about debt, talking about just limited government, without appealing to the middle class and the fundamental values of this country, which the vast majority of Americans share. If they can't find that message, they're going to get, well, what I think the Democrats deserve. But without that voice...
It's over.
It's amazing.
It's over, not just for the Republicans. It will be over for the country.
Why can't Republicans understand you need voters to support your political agenda?
Yes, and you need to get voters out. And to your point, Republicans have always talked in cold numbers, deficit, unemployment rate, all true. But what the Democrats have done so well for so long is the emotional appeal. The Republicans need to get to the emotional appeal to the voters to get them out.
They're sitting there handing out money by the bucketful across this country.
Right.
And unless, I mean, and Republicans walking around saying, well, we can't give out that much money to people. They've got to come up with a far more persuasive response.
The Republicans have not, in my judgment, had a serious emotional appeal argument since Ronald Reagan's commercial with the bear in the woods. And they haven't gotten to the heartstrings of this country.
I think Obamacare is the answer, though, for that.
And Republicans won in 2010 on Obamacare. So that's part of the overall message. But that's why what you're seeing on the left-hand side of your screen with Ted Cruz
the
is so important
The Tea Party
right
was
now.
A spontaneous eruption of the popular will. It was extinguished by the Obama administration through the IRS targeting and by a Republican establishment that in victory found itself threatened.
Yes.
And the Tea Party right now is not in resurgence. Thank you all. Appreciate it.
Pleasure.
Good to have you with
Thank
us.
You.
Take a second, please, to visit our website at foxbusiness.com. A feature story today offering a revealing look at Twitter's plan to go public. Up next.